Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss a solution for spongy, loose, weak or lack of feedback from the disc brakes. Before starting the video, I would like to say that please make sure to check your brake setup thoroughly after you complete this job. And if you think you need professional help, then please go for it, as brake failure can be fatal. From time to time, air can enter the braking system, making the brakes feel inefficient. For this, bleeding out the air from the system is very important. So let's begin with the work. This is the brake oil reservoir, and below it is the master cylinder, which is connected to the brake lever. So when you press the brake lever, all your muscle force is transferred through this hydraulic system to the calipers below to activate the brakes. Unscrew both the screws holding the reservoir cap. With both the screws gone, remove the brake oil reservoir cap. The white plastic plate which you are seeing here is the cover for diaphragm. Remove this plastic plate. After removing the cover plate, secure the sides of the reservoir with a tissue paper or with an absorbent cloth, as brake fluid is corrosive in nature and if it spills, it can eat onto your motorcycle paint. Take a flathead screwdriver to gently remove the rubber diaphragm from the edges. Now once you're done with the reservoir, it's time to focus on the caliper. Remove the dust cap from the bleeding valve. Fix a flexible pipe on the bleeding valve. You can drop the other end into a container. Now take a 10mm open end spanner and place it on the bleeding valve. Now next few steps are important and repetitive. Now press the brake lever hard, and while it is still pressed, open the bleeding valve with the help of the spanner. Let some brake oil come out from the valve. Close the valve and then release the lever. Repeat this press, open, close, and release method till you feel the brake lever has got back its firmness. In between all this, you have to keep a check on the brake oil level. I am using this .4 brake oil as it has got higher boiling point and better heat resistance capacity. A small suggestion from my side is that always get small bottles of brake oil, as brake oil has moisture absorbing tendency which degrades their performance. So a open bottle of brake oil doesn't have much shelf life. Start assembling the reservoir by putting the diaphragm first. Tap the edges with a flathead screwdriver to ensure it is back in place. Wipe out the excess brake oil if it comes out. Next comes the plastic diaphragm cover. Time to put it back in place. Finally, the reservoir cap sits on the top. Secure it with the two screws. So once everything is all right, remove the pipe and put back the dust cover on the bleeding valve. Now once all this is done, carry out a test ride to check the braking performance. And after the ride, check the braking system for any leaks or cracks.